So does this fight have some Democrats running scared? Some Democratic right-to-work states are facing tough re-elections themselves. They're said to be distancing themselves from this fight. Some of those fellows you just see right there. Former GOP presidential candidate and big-time TV host Mike Huckabee here, not surprised. Governor, it is a sticky wicket for some of these guys, right?
It shouldn't be. It ought to be about jobs. And the fact is, if Boeing doesn't move those jobs to the place where they can most cost-effectively do business, then I'll tell you, the companies that are buying the jets will buy Airbus jets made in Europe instead, because this is a competitive marketplace. And you want to ask some of these folks who are pushing this, got to move them all to Washington, who didn't lose jobs over this, what's wrong with creating 2,000 jobs? Do the people who got those jobs in South Carolina, are they better off than they were when they were unemployed? Aren't their wages far better than most of the wages in the other industries surrounding that Boeing plant? You bet they are. So shouldn't they celebrate the fact that some Americans are getting a paycheck and going home and putting food on their table? Instead, they're complaining that they're not union jobs. You know, an unemployed person doesn't care if it's a union job or a non-union job. They want to go to work.
But there is a vested financial interest here as we go through some of these folks who might or might not be vulnerable and the union money to get. The fact of the matter is they are beholden to unions. That's just a reality.
There is a vicious cycle and circle, if you will, in politics where the money follows the candidate and the candidate follows the money, and it continues to go that way. There are a lot of people, Mary Landrieu down in Louisiana, had a lot of money from unions over the past several years in her tenure as a United States senator. She's being awfully quiet about all this, but she has to be politically. But isn't it time that we say to folks, if you're this beholden to a union, go out there and get you a union job, but the congressional seats and Senate seats ought not to be owned by a union. They ought to be owned by the people and what's in their best interest. And it's in their best interest to get jobs in America, not in Europe, not in Mexico, and for heaven's sakes, not in China.
You know what I thought of too, Governor? Imagine if this case doesn't go ultimately Boeing's way. I know there are a lot of fights back and forth, Seattle courthouse, and that could be appealed to a federal court, which goes potentially all the way to the Supreme Court. But if it's ruled that Boeing overstepped itself, 1,000 people lose their jobs.
Well, and not only do they lose their jobs, but what will that do to the future of businesses in this country expanding? They're simply not going to be wanting to risk not just the loss of $1 billion construction of a plant, but those jobs that they created. But the litigation cost and the loss of time that they're going to be tied up in court. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to drive more jobs out of this country and fewer Americans will have a job to go to. That is the nuttiest
thing.
Well,
it's a scary thing. You know, on this show, I've had a number of CEOs on. I know you get some big time guests, but I get Fortune 500 guests.
Yes, you do.
Kind of a big deal, as you know, Governor. But in all seriousness, one of them told me, what's to stop us from saying, we see the grief that Boeing's going through. Agree or disagree, it's not worth the headache. We'll just go to China. We'll go to Latin America. We'll go anywhere else, but deal with the grief we would have to deal with here.
Capital is like water. It always flows to the course of least resistance. And so if capital is going to hit a wall of resistance from the unions, it will simply flow in a different direction away from the unions. If it hits government regulatory impediments, it'll flow away from that and to go where there's not those government regulatory impediments. This is why this is, an employment mission of suicide for the government to so intervene to start picking the locations for an American business. Neil, in a bigger sense, to me, this defies the very essence of free market, free enterprise that our economy has been built on, but that we are almost systematically destroying by idiotic actions as being practiced by the National Labor Relations Board.
Well, finally, do you get a sense, Governor, that Democrats are kind of teasing Republicans on this? Come on, go ahead. Go bash these union guys. Go bash what unions represent and are trying to do, and we'll win that battle.
Well, they won't win that battle because unions have decided to put virtually 100% of their support in Democrats. So Republicans politically have nothing to lose by beating up on unions. If unions had been smart, They would have salted both sides of the political aisle. They might have given 75% to Democrats, but they would have given just enough to Republicans to keep them from going completely against them. Now, they have the Republicans owe unions nothing but a beating about the head, and that's what they're going to get. There is no political consequence to the Republicans beating up on the unions. Zero. And here's the other side of that. There is no political advantage for a Democrat sucking up to the union because the unions have nowhere else to go. This is a dumb political move on the part of the unions, and it has been for a generation.
Real quick, any regrets about not joining this race?
The only regret is that you refused to be my running mate, and therefore I said, to heck with
no,
this whole process.
You thought of that and said, I'm staying out. I'm staying out. But no, everyone is diving in, it seems.
Well, you know, it's still a wide open race. I think there's hopefully an opportunity to change the leadership in this country.
Do you have any horse that you like?
I like most. Well, I'll put it this way. I like all of them. And I think any one of the people right now on the Republican stage, I'll say it this way, every day of the week and twice on Sunday would do a better job than this president of getting jobs and the economy back on track.